In this video, we will discuss about the equations of motion by calculus method. So here we are going to derive the equations of motion by calculus method. Now, first of all, let us understand some of the formulas of integration, because that we are going to use in this method. So our first is, this symbol is known as an integration. The symbol is integration. Integration means addition. So if you want to integrate this function only dx, then the integration of dx is x plus c. If suppose I want to integrate another one function, that is x raised to power n into dx, then the integration of this function x raised to power n will be equal to x raised to power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. So these are the two formulas which we are going to use in this method. Now to understand it, let us do some of the examples. For example, I want to integrate this dx. So here I want to integrate this function for minus 1 to 1. Means I am adding this function from minus 1 to 1. So we know that the integration of dx is simple x, so if I put it here x, and I make a square bracket to put the lower limit and upper limit, means from minus 1, that is minus 1 to 1. So mean you are adding from minus 1 to 1. Now put the value of upper limit in place of x, so it is 1. And minus the lower limit. So here lower limit is minus 1. So put the value of lower limit in place of x. So it is minus 1. So after solving it, you will get it is equal to 2. So this is how we integrate a function. Similarly, I take another one example. Suppose I want to integrate x raised to power 3 into dx, and I am adding this function from minus 1 to 1 again. So if you want to integrate this function, so I will use this second one formula. So here if you see, it is x raised to power n, so power is increased by 1 and you divide that power. So here it is. It is x raised to power 3, it becomes 4 divided by 4. Again, same lower limit, that is minus 1 and 1. Now put the upper limit in place of x. So it is 1 by 4 minus the lower limit. Put the value of x minus 1 here. So it is power minus 1, power 4 divided by 4. So after solving it, you will get it is equal to 1 by 4 and it is minus 1 by 4, and it gave rise to a 0 value. Example, suppose I want to integrate this third one, 3x square. I am allowed to add minus 1 to 1 into dx. So this is your function. This function I want to integrate. So this is sign of integration and with respect to what? Dx. So if you want to integrate, so 3 is a constant. So 3 I can take it outside. So we are left with x square into dx minus 1 to 1. So if you integrate it, so you know the power is increased by 1, 3 into x power 3 divided by 3. Now same minus 1 to 1. Lower limit minus into upper limit. So 3 into put the value of x upper limit, that is 1 by 3 minus the lower limit, minus the lower limit is minus 1. So minus 1 का होल क्यूब डिवाइड बाय 3. सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग इट यू विल गेट इट इज इक्वल टू 3 इंटू 1 बाई 3 माइनस 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 बिकम्स प्लस 1 बाई 3. सो इट इज 6 बाई 3 और इट इज 2. सो द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस फंक्शन इज इक्वल टू 2. तो सिमिलरली वी कैन फाइंड अ डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ इंटीग्रेशंस. सो नाउ कम टू बैक टू द अवर ओरिजिनल प्रॉब्लम. सो दैट इज इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन बाय कैलकुलस मेथड. सो जनरली वी नो दैट देर आर 3 इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशंस. द फर्स्ट वन इज वी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी. द सेकेंड वन इज एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वेयर. एंड द थर्ड वन इज वी स्क्वेयर माइनस यू स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू 2as. सो वी हैव 3 इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन. सो नाउ बिफोर डिराइविंग ऑल दीज इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन लेट अस कंसिडर फर्स्ट अ सिचुएशन. सो आई कंसिडर इनिशियली दिस इज एनी ऑब्जेक्ट विच वॉज इनिशियली मूविंग विद अ वेलोसिटी यू एट अ टाइम टी इक्वल टू 0. Now this body is acted upon by some acceleration. I take that acceleration is a. As a result, the object's velocity is increased to v. So at a time t. Now during this motion, this body has covered a distance of s. Or I can take it x also. Now, I assume here the acceleration of this particle is uniform. The acceleration with which this particle is moving is constant or uniform. Now, I am going to derive the first equation. So, I will derive the first equation by using the definition of acceleration. So, acceleration is time rate change of velocity. So it is dv by dt. So cross multiplying it. So what we get? Dv is equal to a into dt. So this is your small change in velocity is equal to acceleration multiplied by the very small time interval. But I want to calculate what is a definite change in the velocity. So I have to add all these small velocities. So mean to say that we want to integrate it. So after integrating, dv is equal to a dt. Now here velocity in this problem is changing from u to v. So it is changing from u to v. So time is changing from 0 to t. 0 to t. Now integrating it, so what we get? So after solving, the integration of dv is simple v, because integration of dx is x. So again same problem, it is lower limit and it is upper limit. Is equal to, here a is uniform, so a is uniform means constant, so I can take it outside. So we are left with 0 to t into dt. So we know that what is the integration of only dt, it is t. A is already there. So now 0 to t. Now we put the limits. So first we put the upper limit, that is v, minus put the value of u in this equation. So that is u. Now here a is constant, so it is t minus 0. So after solving it, you will get v is equal to u plus a t. So this is our first equation of motion. So this is how we can able to derive the first equation of motion by calculus method. I am going to derive now second equation of motion. So I will start this with a definition of instantaneous velocity. So it is a time rate change of displacement. So velocity is equal to dx divided by dt. Cross multiplying it, what we get? Dx is equal to v into dt. Now if you put the value of first equation of motion using v is equal to u plus at, so the above equation becomes, so dx will be equal to u plus at into dt. So again you solve little bit, so what do you get? U dt plus at dt. So this is your displacement, but I want to know what is the total displacement from u to v. So when you want to calculate the total, so you do integration. To calculate total change in the position, so what we get? So we integrate it, dx, this part also integrate, u into dt, and this part also we will integrate, that is at into dt. Now we should put the limits. So here you can see the position d is attached with the x, x means position. So here if you see the example, so here the your position is changing from 0 to this distance, that is s. So the, our limit will should be 0 to s. So it will be 0 to s. Here t is attached to the time, so it is timing changing from 0 to t. This is also 0 to t. Now we know that integration of only dx is simple x, 0 to s, and u is the initial velocity for a particular problem u. So I can take it outside integration, so 0 to t into dt. If you want to solve this also, so a is uniform, so I can take it outside, so we are left with only t into dt. Now put the limits, first put the value of x, upper limit, that is s, minus the lower limit, that is 0. So here u, what is the integration of dt? That is simple t, and again 0 to t. Plus a, now here it is d into dt, so here the power of time is 1, so we know that is power is increased by 1, that is 2 divided by 2, 0 to t. So further if you solve little bit, so it is s is equal to u upper limit, that is t, plus a upper limit t square by 2 minus lower limit is 0. So further we get ut plus half at square. So this is nothing but it is our second equation of motion. If we are able to know the three values, we can find out the fourth one to derive third equation of motion. In third equation of motion, the acceleration is, so here acceleration is time rate change of velocity. So acceleration is equal to dv divided by dt. So here I do some changes here, little bit rearranging the term. So dv I divide it by dx and multiply with x. So here dv by dt is already there, just multiplying with dx and divide it by dx. So we know that what is dx by dt, this already we have done, it is nothing but it is the instantaneous velocity, that is dx by dt. So if you put the value, so what we get? Dv divided by dx. This is v dv by dx. Now rearranging the term, so a is equal to v into dv divided by dx. So after cross multiplying, so what do we get? A dx is equal to v dv. So here again I want to calculate the total change. So total, how to calculate? So we integrate it. So to calculate total change, we are going to integrate this. So after integrating this one also, adx and v dv integration. So here dx position is changing from 0 to s, and here it is velocity. So velocity is changing from u to v. If you solve little bit, a is uniform, so I can take it outside, and we are left with only dx. 0 say s is equal to, you see here it is v into dv, so we cannot take it outside. So here the power of v is 1, so power is increased by 1, that is 2 divided by 2, so that is u v. So further, if you solve little bit, so what we get? A, integration of dx is simple x, 0 to s, and here upper limit, that is v square by 2, minus lower limit, that is u square by 2. So further, if you solve it, it is s minus 0. So 1 by 2 is common, so it is v square minus u square. So further, if you solve little bit, this as is equal to 1 by 2 v square minus u square. So 2 you take that side, so what we get? 2 as is equal to v square minus u square. So this is our third equation of motion. So how we are able to derive these three equation of motion? You just remember, these three equation of motions are v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as.